In this presentation, we are going to see about the power plant selection. These are some of the topics we are going to cover in this presentation: introduction, history of jet engine, working principle, types and applications. Introduction. A jet engine is a type of reaction engine which discharges a fast moving jet that produces thrust by jet propulsion. The term jet engine typically refers to an air-breathing jet engine such as turbojet, turbofan, turboshaft and ramjets. Next comes the history of jet engine. The first jet engine was built by Egyptian scientists during 100 BC. During World War II, Germany was the only nation to fly a gas turbine propelled aircraft in actual combat. There are two types of jet propulsion engines, the rocket and the gas turbine engine. Next comes the working of jet engine. A fan at the front sucks the cold air into the engine and forces it through the inlet. Next, the air enters the compressor where the temperature and pressure of air increases due to compression. Then, compressed air is sprayed with fuel, which in turn ignition takes place. Then the burning gases expands and blast out through the nozzle at the back of the engine. This in turn creates a thrust which makes the aircraft to move forward. Next comes the part of jet engine. As you seen in this video, the inlet duct is the opening in front of the aircraft that allows the outside air to enter the engine. Next, the compressor. It compresses the air and makes the flow much more powerful. The compression happens in stages that forces the incoming air into one increasingly inner chamber. A row of rotating blades and stator vanes is called a stage. The compressor delivers outside air to the inlet section and passes this air through the inlet guide vanes. In turn, the inlet guide vanes deflect the air in the direction of compressor rotation. The rotating blades arrest the airflow and pass it to a set of stationary stator vanes. The air is again deflected and picked up by another set of rotating blades. The pressure of air increases each time and it passes through a set of rotors and stators because the areas of these rotors and stators get smaller. Next is the combustion chamber. The efficiency and performance of a turbine power unit depend on the type of combustion system used. Fuel enters in front of the burner as an atomized spray or in a pre-vaporized form. Air flows in around the fuel and nozzle through the first row of the combustion air holes in the liner. Air near the burner nozzle stays close to the front liner wall for cooling and cleaning purposes. Air entering the forward section of the liner recirculates and moves upstream against the fuel spray. During combustion, this action permits rapid mixing and prevents flame blowout by forming a low velocity stabilization zone. This zone acts as a continuous pilot for the rest of the burner. Gases that result from the combustion process have temperature approximately 1900 degrees Celsius. Before entering the turbine, these gases must be cooled to about half of this value. Therefore, secondary air which enters through a set of relatively large holes located towards the rear of the liner, which dilutes and cools the hot gases. Next is the turbine. The turbine assembly drives the compressor and accessories by extracting some of the energy and pressure from the combustion gases. Last is the exhaust cone. It is attached to the rear of the turbine assembly. It is a tapered, cylinder-shaped outlet for the gases. The cone eliminates turbulence in the emerging jet, thereby giving maximum velocity. Next comes the Brayton cycle. It is a thermodynamic cyclic process. In this, A to B represents adiabatic quasi-static compression in the inlet and in compressor. B to C represents the constant pressure fuel combustion. C to D represents adiabatic quasi-static expansion in the turbine and exhaust nozzle with which we can take some work out of the air and use it to drive the compressor, and take the remaining work out and use it to accelerate fluid for jet propulsion or to turn a generator for electrical power generation. D2A represents to cool the air at constant pressure back to its initial condition. Next comes the turbofan. The word turbofan is a combination of turbine and fan. The turbo portion refers to a gas turbine engine which takes mechanical energy from combustion, and ducted fan that uses the mechanical energy from the gas turbine to accelerate air rearwards. This is the turbofan. Next comes the turboprop. The turboprop engine is a turbine engine that drives an aircraft propeller. It is developed to provide the power requirements for aircraft greater size, carrying capacity, range and speed. The turboprop converts most of its gas energy into mechanical power to drive the compressor, accessories and a propeller. This is the turboprop engine. Next comes the turboshaft. Turboshaft engines have a high power to weight ratio and are widely used in helicopters. It is in the form of a gas turbine which is optimized to produce shaft power rather than jet thrust. This is the turboshaft. Next comes a ramjet. A ramjet powered vehicle therefore requires an assisted takeoff like a rocket assist to accelerate it to a speed where it begins to produce thrust. Ramjets work most efficiently at supersonic speeds around Mach 3. These are some of the applications of jet engine. The first use of the jet engine was to power military aircraft. Normal type of jet engine is used for domestic purposes, that is for traveling, carrying goods, etc. And also it is used as an industrial gas turbine for power generation, natural gas, oil pumps, etc. Thank you.